Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about that is adsorption, and as well as we have also talked about the types of adsorption, and we are now specifically talking about what are the factors that will depend on that is adsorption of a gas on a solid. So what are those? Let us talk about them. So friends, we know that the gas can easily get adsorbed on the solid unless we provide certain kind of the condition. So there are certain factors that will depend on that is the adsorption of the gas on the solid. And what are those factors? This is what we are going to talk about in this lecture. So now we are going to discuss about the factors that will affect the adsorption of the gas on a particular solid. So let us talk about that. So these are the factors that will affect on that is the adsorption of the gas on the solid. So talking about the first one, that is the nature of adsorbent. Yes, adsorbent is the one that is get deposited on a particular surface of the adsorbent, and that is what in this case basically we are discussing about the gas. So when we are talking about the adsorbent, we are talking about the gas which has basically higher critical temperature. And what is critical temperature? Let me talk about that one. So basically we are discussing about the nature of the adsorbate. So therefore when it comes to the nature of adsorbate, we should always discuss that or always concerned with the critical temperature of the gas. And what is critical temperature? So critical temperature means the temperature above which the gas cannot be liquefied. So that means that if we are having such kind of gas which has higher critical temperature, that means we have to provide higher temperature so that the gas will sustain in gaseous state only. Or meanwhile, we could say that if a particular gas has a higher critical temperature, that means that kind of gas can be easily liquefiable. So if the gas can be easily liquefiable, then we know that can be easily deposited on the solid, because we know that gas cannot we cannot deposit gas directly unless we provide certain kind of condition. But suppose if that kind of gas that is to be deposited on this particular solid, or we could call it as on a particular adsorbent, then we should know that that gas should have higher critical temperature. If that gas has higher critical temperature, means that gas can be easily liquefiable, and if the gas get easily liquefied, so that can be deposited on the solid very easily. So that's the reason that the critical temperature plays a very vital role, and such kind of gases which have actually higher critical temperature are being basically we could say like NH3. So NH3, compared to other gas, it can be easily liquefiable. So when it comes to NH3 or when it comes to SO2, so even SO2 is the one that can be easily liquefiable. So this kind of gases can be easily get adsorbed on a particular solid, or we could say on a particular adsorbent. So these are the one which has higher critical temperature. But for certain gas, like if you could call like for oxygen, so oxygen cannot be easily liquefiable, and that is what we know. So because it has lower critical temperature, and that's the reason we have to provide much more lesser temperature, then only the gas can be converted into its liquid state. So that's the reason oxygen, or we could call it as nitrogen, even to make liquid nitrogen, we have to provide very much low temperature, then only that kind of nitrogen gas can be easily liquefiable, and once it gets liquefied, it can be easily deposited on the particular solid. But usually it doesn't happen because of this kind of that is gas, they have basically low critical temperature. So it depends on the gases also, that what kind of critical temperature that it has. So this was the point that I was talking about, the nature of the adsorbent. And now let us talk about the next point that we are going to talk about, and that is, yes, that is nature of adsorbent. So what would be the nature of the adsorbent? For example, we know that this is all what we are talking about, the adsorption. And the adsorption is a surface phenomenon. And if the adsorbent on which basically different kind of gases, or we could say like the adsorption happens, or we could say that the gas gets deposited on the surface of the adsorbent. So if the surface is large, or we have more the surface, then we could say that more amount of gas can be deposited on the surface of the adsorbent. So that's the reason that the surface area of the adsorbent also depends on it. So if the adsorbent area is more, or surface area is more, then we could say that more amount of gas can be easily deposited. So it depends on the nature of adsorbent also. So now let us talk, for example, like for second one, like there are various examples like that of rhenium nickel that we have discussed, activated charcoal, tungsten and all. So these are the nature of adsorbent. If they have more the surface area, more the gas can be easily deposited on it. And so similarly, we could say that is the third point that we have, and that is basically surface area of the adsorbent. Yes, this is what we have discussed in the second part only. But suppose if I have a radical, and suppose if I have a that is a film of or a surface of a that is nickel, and on which basically we have to deposit basically H2 gas. So H2 gas can be easily, that is, it can be deposited on it because of that is the adsorption or because of the adsorption that takes place between the adsorbent and the adsorbate, and in that case the adsorbate is H2 gas. So that can be easily deposited. But what happens if I crush the nickel, or if I reduce, or if I make the pieces of the nickel so as we could say that the size of the nickel gets reduced? So if the size of the nickel gets reduced, then more the surface area will be, the overall surface area would be more. And that's the reason more amount of H2 or more amount of the gas can be easily deposited on the solid nickel. And that is what we call that the surface, it depends on the surface area of the adsorbent also. So for example, like charcoal. So charcoal, suppose if we have a piece of charcoal and on which suppose we have to deposit the hydrogen gas. So we know that it can get deposited on it, or it can get adsorbed on the charcoal. But what if we crush the charcoal? So if we crush the charcoal, or that is what we have made the powder of the charcoal, and then we are that is making a process where we could deposit the H2 gas on the powder charcoal. So more amount of the H2 is needed so as to that is cover up all the particles of the powder charcoal. So that's the reason that we are increasing the surface area, and meanwhile we are increasing the gases to get deposit on the powder charcoal. So this has happened only because of once we have increases the surface area of the charcoal, and that is what it happens. So for gas to be deposited on the solid, we should assure this first three things, that is, we should assure the nature of adsorbate, we should assure the nature of the adsorbent, we should consider that, and ultimately we should call about the, that is, the surface area of the adsorbent. So these are the things that is concerned about the adsorbent as well as the adsorbate. So now talking about the next one, that is the fourth point, and the fourth point is basically it depends on the temperature of the surface. So we have discussed earlier only, that is, if we provide less temperature, or if we provide low temperature, then we could say that the adsorption can increase till a maximum extent. But when the temperature is increased, obviously we have to deposit the gas on a particular solid. So if we are increasing the temperature, and gas has the property that if we increase the temperature, then the gas will expand. But we need the gas to be deposited on the solid, for which we have to, that is, we have to provide low temperature, because at that temperature or not, at low temperature, the gas can be easily liquefied. And once the gas can be easily liquefied, so it can be deposited easily on the solid. So that is what we are concerned with. So therefore the temperature of the surface is also playing a very vital role. So and talking about the next point, that is when I am talking about the last one, that is pressure. So obviously the pressure of an adsorbing gas. So obviously if we apply more pressure, then it is but obvious that in such a high pressure, we could see that the gas can be easily deposited on the solid, and that is what it happens. But now let me give you a small idea that how the temperature and pressure, they affect the adsorption. So that is, this is what I want to discuss about. So let me give you an example. Suppose this is the graph that I'm mentioning about here. Suppose this is the graph for pressure, and this is for, that is, I'm mentioning for volume. And for which we know that if the pressure increases, then this volume is basically the volume of the gas that is deposited on the solid, and this is the pressure that is being applied on the gas or the adsorbing gas. So suppose if we are increasing the pressure, obviously we could see that the volume of the gas that gets deposited, that will go on increasing. So it will increase till a particular extent, and after a meanwhile we could see that it gets constant. So this is what, this is the graph that we obtain over here. So suppose if this is the graph that has been obtained at a particular temperature, and that temperature is suppose like T1. So this is the temperature that we have. And now let us discuss about the other one. So that is, suppose there is another condition where we have that is we are following the same graph, or we are following the same method, that is, we are adsorbing the gas at a particular pressure on a particular solid. So suppose we are talking about the temperature T2. So in this case, suppose if the temperature T2 is very much that is, it is greater than that of T1, then but always we will get to know that is the volume of the gas that has been deposited on the solid, it will get reduced, even though if we are applying pressure. So even though if we are applying more pressure, then the volume is getting reduced. So even though we are applying high, even though we have to deposit the gas on the solid, but the volume of the gas that is being deposited on the solid, it will be very much less, because in this case T2 is greater than T1. So obviously we could see this kind of graph. So this is what we have. And suppose if I'm introducing another factor where the temperature T3 is very much greater than that of T2, and which is very much greater than that of T1. So suppose this is the condition that we have. And in this case, basically, if we have increased the temperature more, then obviously the volume of the gas that should deposit on the solid, obviously it will decrease. So this is what we will get. So this is the graph, or this is the graph that indicates that if we increase the temperature, then the volume, or even though if by increasing the pressure, we'll get this kind of criteria, or this kind of the things that we could get. And suppose if we are comparing it with a particular pressure, suppose here. So this is the pressure, suppose this is the pressure that I'm talking about. So even though at this pressure, if we are applying this much pressure and the temperature is less, then we could find that the volume, that is the volume of the gas that has been deposited, is comparatively high, and that is suppose V1. So if I am comparing this with the temperature T2, that is the pressure that I am applying, and in that case the temperature is, suppose if it is more than the gas that has been deposited, it is called to be V2, which is very much less than compared to that of V1. And ultimately, finally, we could say for that is at temperature T3, the volume of the gas that has been deposited or that has been adsorbed on the adsorbent is V3, so which indicates that V3 is very much less than that of V2, and which is very much less than that of V1. So it clearly indicates that if the temperature is more, the adsorption will be less. So this were the few that is criteria, or few that is the things that we have to observe, and that are the factors that we are talking about. So these are the factors that we should make sure whenever a gas has been deposited on a solid. So that is what I was talking about. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have understood the various factors that depends on the adsorbing of a gas on a solid. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, I hope you won't forget to subscribe to me channel. Thank you so much.